Hey guys, I'm Valian. If you guys want to catch me live, I stream on Twitch and sometimes TikTok. I'm excited to share this build with you guys. I hope you enjoy. This build was crazy good preseason. Now it's just broken, I think. It's too good. I started with Nightmare Dungeons 20 levels above me with unoptimized gear. And it was still really easy. I was missing all the lucky hit, which is a big component in this build. The gameplay will prove that. For our abilities, we are going to be using Blood Howl. Blood Howl heals you for 25% of your maximum life. Each kill reduces the cooldown of Blood Howl by 1 second, and Blood Howl also increases your attack speed by 15% for 4 seconds. The next skill we're going to be taking is Hurricane. Hurricane acts as a defensive and an offensive ability as well. Enemies who are damaged by Hurricane are slowed by 25% for 2 seconds. Enemies affected by Hurricane deal 20% less damage. Hurricane has many purposes. It spreads vulnerability, it spreads the poison damage, which slows and helps us crit in AoE scenarios, and it helps us stack loot bind ferocity as well. The third skill we're going to be taking is Debilitating Roar. It's probably the best defensive ability for druids. Fortifies you for 22% of your life. All enemies around you deal 70% less damage for 4 seconds. They are all also slowed for 65%. For our ultimate, we're going to be taking Grizzly Rage. It's a defensive, offensive, like all the other abilities. You gain 20% bonus damage and 20% damage reduction. Damage bonus is increased by 3% each second while in this form. We're pretty much always going to be in Grizzly Rage. You also gain 8% of your life. It's like a hill over time just ticking on you the whole time. And the most obvious bonus to this is we're unstoppable. Our basic ability is going to be Claw. This is going to be our main source of damage. Claw's attack speed is increased by 15%. Claw has a 15% chance to attack twice. And paired with the unique Great Staff of Crone, it triggers Storm Strike as well. And this is what the whole build's going to be built around. And finally, we're going to be taking Cyclone Armor. We have 0 points in Cyclone Armor, but it fits the build. It's technically a defensive ability. We're also using it as like a interrupt. Whenever you think you're going to be hit by anything or you need to get out of a sticky situation, you just pop a Cyclone Armor and you knock everything back. For our gear, we're using Tempest 4, Mad Wolf's Glee, and the Great Staff of Crone. So besides the uniques, our aspects are going to be Overcharge for our gloves. It's a lucky hit, 10 to 20%. It's 20% chance when dealing lightning damage to overload the target for 3 seconds, causing any direct damage you deal to them to pulse for additional damage. Before extracting this from an item, be sure to upgrade the armor piece. The aspect will upgrade as well. Most of the time, it's better to get the aspect from the codex because it scales with your level, but the lucky hit chance stays at 10%. If you are lucky enough to find a 20% with higher stats, use that. The aspect that we're going to be using for our pants is Disobedience. It's just survivability, stacking armor. For our boots, we're going to be using the aspect of Dark Owl. It is good for survivability, and a lot of your damage works off of Immobilize as well. For the amulet, we're going to use the aspect Rapid. The whole build is based off of basic attacks, and this gives your basic attack up to 45% more attack speed. For the rings, we're going to use the aspect of Werebeast and Direwolf. Werebeast increases the duration of your Grizzly Rage by up to 5 seconds. In addition, it stacks crit for you. And Direwolf allows Grizzly Rage to be used as a werewolf. These two aspects are pretty much necessary because the main goal of the build is to keep the downtime of Grizzly Rage as low as possible. This is because while you're in Grizzly Rage, everything is increased, your damage, your survivability, your life leech, even your movement speed, spirit cost reduction, even though we're not using core skills. Since we aren't using any core abilities on our gloves, we're going to focus on attack speed, critical damage, lucky hit, and storm skill cooldown, just to keep Hurricane up as often as possible. For our pants, we should be focusing on defensive stats, total armor, dodge, damage reduction, max life. For the boots, we want movement speed, total armor while in werewolf form, dodge chance, damage reduction, stats. And be sure to socket the Great Staff of Crone with basic skill damage, because that is going to be the majority of our damage. For our amulet, movement speed, defensive stats to help with higher tier nightmare dungeons, flat cooldown reduction, keep up grizzly rage as much as possible, and hurricane. We're only going to be getting lucky hit from our gloves and our rings. This stat alone increases our overall damage and our tankiness, because it affects how often we leech life. And the next preferred stats would be vulnerable damage, critical strike damage, critical strike chance, max life. Our other forms of damage are also good. The hearts that we are currently using are Devious Heart for pulling all enemies into us while we have Grizzly Rage active. It helps a lot because we're melee, helps with clear speed. I'm currently using Vicious Heart. Critical strikes electrically charge the enemy, causing lightning to arc between them, and we already do this on our own. It's a massive damage output. For the next heart, we're going to be using Brutal Heart. We're not really using this for damage, but we're using it for the flat damage reduction. The damage helps as well, just not significant. Other heart options would be the Malignant Pact. The only thing that it rotates between three different stats. One of them is really good for us, the other two are not. The attack speed, 20%. Creeping Death is another good option. I haven't tested it out yet, though. It increases your damage over time effects. And we do poison damage on all our crits. And the Barber. Critical strikes and all subsequent damage within 2 to 4 seconds is absorbed by your target. Then the absorbed damage erupts onto surrounding enemies. Stored damage is increased by a percentage per second. Ideally, the lower the time on this is the better. Because when this is proccing, your targets are immune until the damage erupts. So you don't want everything staying up for 4 seconds until it all blows up. Another really good option for survivability is the Unconstrained Beast. When you are hit with a stun, freeze, or knockdown effect, there is a 40 to 60% chance to automatically activate Grizzly Rage for 3 seconds, for 4 seconds, which increases our survivability, our damage, everything. But in my opinion, the most necessary one is Inexorable Force. The one that drags enemies towards us when we are using an ultimate skill. For our spirit boon, we want to be using Wariness, take 10% reduced damage from elites. Swooping attacks, attack speed is the key for this build. Calamity, extend the duration of ultimate skills by 25%. And then we're going to be taking Masochistic. Critical strikes with shape-shifting skills have up to a 75% chance to heal you for 3% maximum life, and Calm Before the Storm, just to help increase the uptime of our ultimate Grizzly Rage. For our skill tree, we are going to be maxing out Claw, 1 point into Enhanced Claw, and 1 point into Wild Claw. Then we're going to max out Storm Strike, Enhanced Storm Strike, and Fierce Storm Strike. We take 0 core abilities besides a passive, which is Predatory Instinct. In the defensive tree, we get 2 more passives, 1 point into Ancestral Fortitude and 3 points into Vigilance, 1 point into Blood Howl, Enhanced Blood Howl, and Preserving Blood Howl, 1 point into Debilitating Roar, Enhanced and Innate Debilitating Roar. The companion tree, we're just going to skip altogether. In the Rascals, 1 point is a Hurricane, 1 point to Enhanced Hurricane, and 1 point is a Savage Hurricane. We're going to put 1 point into Elemental Exposure, and 1 point into Charged Atmosphere, 3 points into Electric Shock, 3 points into Bad Omen, and 3 points into Endless Tempest. Next, we're going to put 1 point in Neurotoxin and 1 point in Toxic Claws. You only need 1 point in Toxic Claws. We're just using this to spread poison onto everything that we attack with Hurricane or our basic attack, which allows us to do more damage. We're going to place 3 points into Envenom. Poisoned enemies take 30% additional critical strike damage, and that's why we need the 1 point into Toxic Claws, just so we keep everything poisoned. For our ultimate tree, we're going to put 1 point into Defiance, 3 points into Natural Disaster, and 3 points into resonance. 1 point to Grizzly Rage, 1 point to Prime Grizzly Rage, and Supreme Grizzly Rage. For our key passive, we're going to be taking Lupine Ferocity. Every 6 attack will crit and deal 70% increased damage. Hurricane will build this, and we have massive attack speed in this build, so this is going to be proccing a lot more than you think it will. But now I'm going to show some short gameplay and then get into the Paragon points, then an overview of the build. For our Paragon board, we're going to go up and to the right. We're going to take the damage node prime. For our glyph, right now it's Fulminate. That's going to change later on. This is just for leveling. The next rare node is Impel. The next board's going to be the Thunderstruck board. We're going to make our way to the right, take the rare node Tempest. Take the legendary node Thunderstruck. The next rare node, Deluge. And our glyph's going to be Fang and Claw. And we'll take the rare nodes around it and make our way to the Constricting Tendrils board. Our glyph's going to be Territorial, and we'll grab the rare nodes around that as well. Make our way out. Our next board's going to be to the north, the Lust for Carnage board. I currently don't have any points into it. I already made a guide for this build in preseason, so I'll have the guide linked down below with the updated hearts. This is the full Paragon board setup, level 100 maxed out from my previous build. Okay guys, for the Paragon boards, first we go right. The first glyph is going to be Werewolf. The next board will be Thunderstruck. And the second glyph will be Fang and Claw. The next board is going to be Constricting Tendrils. The glyph will be Territorial. And then we go north from there to the Lust for Carnage board. The glyph that we are going to be taking is Undaunted. This is more of an optional glyph. We could also swap it out for Fulminate, Guzzler. And later on, I will be swapping this out for Fulminate, most likely. We're going to go left to the next board, which is going to be Ancestral Guidance. And be sure to pick up all the basic skill damage nodes as well. From this board alone, for the minimal investment that we are putting in, we are going to be picking up 70 basic skill damage. It's massive. The glyph that we are going to be picking up is Exploit. And for the final board, we're going to move from the Thunderstruck board and go to Heightened Malice. I honestly believe this is the best Paragon setup. We pick up all the damage. We min-max as much as possible. Thank you guys for watching. If you guys enjoyed the video, please don't forget to subscribe and let me know what you think. See you guys next time.